வணக்கம், நமஸ்தே. ஐ எம் உலகநாதன். ஐ எம் ஏ ரிட்டையர்ட் சயின்டிஸ்ட் ஃப்ரம் டிஆர்டிஓ, டிஃபென்ஸ் ரிசர்ச் அண்ட் டெவலப்மெண்ட் ஆர்கனைசேஷன் அட் பெங்களூர். ஐ எம் கோயிங் டு இன்ட்ரொடியூஸ் யூ ஹோமியோபதி. ஐ எம் நாட் ஏ மெடிக்கல் பர்சன், ஐ எம் அன் எலக்ட்ரானிக்ஸ் இன்ஜினியர், பட் ஐ ஹவ் பீன் யூஸிங் ஹோமியோபதி ஃபார் த லாஸ்ட் 25 இயர்ஸ். சம்படி ஹாஸ் இன்ட்ரொடியூஸ் மீ திஸ் ஹோமியோபதி 25 இயர்ஸ் பேக், அண்ட் ஐ ஹவ் பீன் யூஸிங் இட். And I have been very successful in treating day-to-day ailments for myself, for my family, friends and relatives. I want to share my experience with you people so that you can also start using homeopathy for your day-to-day ailments and get benefited. Let us go into the details.
I made 7 videos on homeopathy and uploaded on YouTube. 1. Introduction, first aid, digestion, cold and cough, fever, other ailments, and finally conclusion. Welcome to part 3 on digestion problems. If you have not seen the earlier parts, you can search YouTube with the keywords homeopathy introduction, homeopathy introduction English, Ulaganathan. Our digestive system is a beautiful mechanism. If you take a little bit of care and follow some rules, it will perform its function efficiently and provide the needed energy for our body. But mostly we misuse it, torture it, and ultimately we spoil it. Before going into details of homeomedicines for stomach problems, we will see how to prevent stomach problems by following a set of self-discipline rules. Please listen patiently. Rule number 1. Eat only when you are hungry. When the energy level in our body goes down, digestive juice, mostly hydrochloric acid, is produced in stomach. That's the hunger sensation. Food should enter stomach only after the acid is produced. In that condition only, digestion will be complete. All nutrients will be fully absorbed by digestive organs. So the saying, eat only when hungry. But we'll violate and eat indiscriminately. Food received in the absence of digestive juice, stomach will find it difficult to handle. It has to just push the undigested or partially digested food down. If this practice continues over a period, the entire chain of digestive system may develop complications. So it is sensible to eat only when we are hungry. Rule number 2. Do not leave an hungry stomach empty for long. When hunger comes, do not delay eating unnecessarily. That is also not correct. If food is not available after digestive juice is produced, the acid may damage the inner linings of the stomach. If this practice is continued for long, it may end up getting ulcer in stomach. So, never leave a hungry stomach empty. Do not give excuse that you are away from home or no hotel nearby. Take some available fruits like banana or at least a glass of water to pacify the acid already secreted. Never take coffee, tea or aerated drinks when you are hungry. It will increase the acidity. I have noticed many housewives complaining of acidity problems. They have poor eating habits. They are busy cooking. When hungry, easiest thing is to take a cup of coffee or tea and postpone eating. That will cause acidity, and this is the main cause for their stomach related problems. Instead, they can take some solid food or just a fruit to pacify hunger. One more thing, breakfast and lunch can be heavy, but not dinner. You don't require that much of energy when you are going to sleep within few hours. Sleeping children should never be woken up and forced food. Your love for child not to go hungry will do more harm. So, leave them to sleep peacefully. Rule number 3. While eating, do not take water. It will dilute the digestive juice and will reduce the efficiency of digestion. After half an hour, you can take as much water as you want. But remember to drink water later. They say that minimum of 2 liters of water one should drink per day. Elderly people do not feel thirsty. They tend to forget drinking water. They should be conscious of drinking water sufficiently to keep away from urinary problems. Rule number 4. Chew well and swallow. Whatever the urgency, food should never be gulped in a hurry. Some may have the practice of taking a sip of water for every mouthful to push down with an excuse that it will stuck in throat. It is to be totally avoided. That's not the way to eat. Solid food should be broken down in mouth. That job should be done by teeth. Realize that stomach do not have such hard teeth. One mouthful taken in inside mouth to be chewed well with lips closed. Air should not come in between food and saliva. Food has to be properly mixed with saliva, made into a paste, then swallowed. Saliva is an important agent in the digestion process. Nothing should go in without the saliva mixing. That applies to water also. While eating, full concentration has to be there. If not aware, by long bad practice, tongue will push it down. Destructive activities like reading, watching TV, or talking should be totally avoided. And if you think that in the current day lifestyle, these practices are not possible, then you are inviting stomach problems with a red carpet reception. You will realize later when suffering from serious stomach ailments. Rule number 5. Every meal should have some fruit and should be eaten first. Fruits are the best of all food. It is enriched with vitamins and minerals. It should be eaten first. Since it is easily digestible and stomach has not much of work to do on it, it will push it down immediately. Apple, don't think apple is the only best fruit. Please do not run after costly apple. Every fruit available easily, locally grown and cheap are also good. Rule number 6. Our meal should have all 6 tastes. Our Indian food has 6 tastes. Sweet, sour, salty, hot or spicy, bitter and finally thuvarpu, we call in Tamil. I do not know the English equivalent word. Those who do not know thuvarpu, it is a taste of raw guava fruit. Our body requires many nutrients like carbohydrates, proteins, fat, minerals and vitamins. But we are not very much aware in what food these contents are available and in what proportions. So easy method is we eat food with all the six tastes in every meal. We may get all the nutrients body requires. At least our full meal lunch should have all the 6 tastes. Green leafy vegetables, commonly call it as keerai in Tamil, soppu in Kannada, even though very cheap, are easy source of rich vitamins and minerals. Rice and wheat are not the only grains. There are variety of millets like ragi, maize, etc. They should be also to be part of our daily meal. General rule is as much variety of vegetables, grains, pulses as possible are to be taken. Rule number 7. Avoid white sugar. Research has linked white sugar to incidence of diabetes. So it is better to avoid white sugar. There are very good alternatives available in variety of forms of jaggery, which is made traditionally out of cane sugar or palm juice. Similarly, avoid refined oils and use our traditional oils. Groundnut oil, sesame oil, coconut oil, prepared cold pressing in conventional mills. There is nothing new in the above rules I have listed. Most of them are known to all, but they are ignored and not followed. The first step to have a perfect digestive system and have good health is to follow these rules without fail. Occasionally, you may land with digestion problems. In that case, homeo comes to our rescue. Stomach upset problems. In case the eaten food is not suitable or spoiled, or you have eaten in excess, within 1 or 2 hours, the stomach will tell you that I am not all right. If you pay attention and take a few doses of a medicine called Podophyllum 30 without delay, the problem will be solved and the stomach will be ready for the next meal. If it is not done, stomach will try to push out the unsuitable food by loose motion. Sometimes it may throw up by vomiting also. It is a natural process to get rid of the indigestible food. We should not stop it immediately by taking some allopathy tablets bought across the counter. When the loose motion sets in, continue the Podophyllum. It will stop only when all the unwanted material in the system is cleared out. In case of food poisoning, diarrhea may be severe. In that case, arsenic alkali also to be taken along with podophyllum alternately. They should be alternated. If vomiting also is there, then Ipecac-30 also to be added. It may take 1 or 2 days for the loose motion to stop. During that period, stomach needs rest. Food has to be restricted. Avoid heavy spicy food. Take mostly liquid diet or easily digestible food. If the loose motion was heavy, the body might have lost fluids. To compensate, we can take few spoons of what is known as an electrol, available in medical stores, allopathy medical stores. Mixed in a tumbler of water. If electrol is not available, add a spoon of common salt and another spoon of sugar in a tumbler of water and take it few times. Long-standing digestion problems. Some might have variety of long-standing stomach problems like not feeling hungry, burning in the food path or in the upper stomach, ulcer in stomach, etc. The main cause for all such ailments are poor eating habits. If they have followed the above said self-discipline rules, most of the ailments related to stomach could have been easily avoided. For such people who are already suffering, to correct their digestive system, Carbaveg 30 is the medicine. Carbaveg 3 times a day before food will help to bring the digestive system back to normal. You may continue it for a week. If required further, leave a gap of 1 or 2 days and continue for a month or till problem gets solved. I have seen mild ulcers, stomach ulcers are getting cured by Carbaveg. If the ulcer is severe, you should consult a homeopath. Wonderful medicines are available to cure completely. Severe ulcer in stomach can be easily cured by homeopathy medicine. For some people, gas may be produced in excess and passing up or down. After few mouths of food, hunger may go off. For such problem, Lycopodium 30 will help. Most of stomach ailments can be solved by combination of Carbaveg and Lycopodium. But one word of caution, I have seen people who got cured by Carbaveg start misusing it. Without following a discipline in eating, Carbaveg will not work. The care you take to keep the digestive system healthy will reflect in keeping the entire body healthy. Finally, we will conclude like this. If you have self-discipline in eating, you may not have stomach problems at all. In case currently you have some problems, homeo will help you to correct. But remember, in the long run, only good habits will keep the digestive system healthy and serve the body to keep it fit. Let us conclude this part 3 and continue in the next video. Some 2 years back, I made similar homeopathy introduction videos in the language Tamil and uploaded on YouTube. Few thousands of views are there. I had also started a WhatsApp group called Homeo Self-Help Tamil Group. I invited people to join the group. Currently, some 135 members are there. It's going very well. The dialogue is in Tamil. On a daily basis, queries are made. To the extent possible, I suggest medicines. Some knowledgeable members also have joined. They also suggest medicine. Members get benefited. So the small group is working very well. Homeopathy is serving to solve their day-to-day ailments. Similar to the Tamil group, I have recently started another group called the Homeo Self-Help English group. You are welcome to join the group. You can send a request message to my number 8050626004 with your name and place. I will admit you. You can post queries in English only and can have a dialogue for a possible cure. In the long run, you will learn how to use homeopathy successfully. I had written a small book in Tamil. The PDF file is made available to members. Those who cannot print the book, members can pay some 100 rupees and get the printed book through courier. The book is popular among members. They read, understand the use of medicines and take care of their family. Similarly, I have written an English book also. After joining the English group, you can request for the PDF file of the English book. If you are unable to print, you can pay and get the printed book through courier. In conclusion, I invite you to start practicing homeopathy with confidence and prayer. God willing, He may bless you for a healthy life through homeopathy. Please leave your comments how useful for this video. If you are interested further, you may join the Homeo Self-Help English group by sending a request message with your name and address. Thank you for your viewing.